Let's move on now to topic number two. And topic number two comes to us from Mike Vodeb, who writes, "Hey, John. So last month it was announced Neill Blombamp would be directing a reboot to Robocop. Neill recently said on Twitter when asked who should play Robocop, and he responded with Peter Weller, the original Robocop. Do you think this would be a good idea, and would Peter want to come back?" All right, thanks a lot for the question. So for those of you who may not have heard about this, yeah, Neill Blombamp, the guy who directed District 9, awesomely. Unfortunately, he also did Chappie and Elysium, but whatever. Neill Blombamp, it was announced he's going to direct a sequel to RoboCop, and much in the vein of Halloween being a sequel to the original Halloween and ignoring all the other Halloweens, and the new Terminator being a sequel to Terminator 2 and ignoring all the other Terminators, this RoboCop is going to be a sequel to the original RoboCop, ignoring all the other RoboCops that came after. That's the idea. So, yes, just, and so you know what he's talking about, somebody asked Neill Blombamp directly on Twitter, like, who do you think's going to be, you know, RoboCop? And Neill Blombamp just said straight up, who should play RoboCop? It's Peter Weller. Peter Weller. So look, this all depends on a couple of things. Number one, it depends on is this sequel set 25 years after the original? If it is, perfect. Peter Weller can come back. If it's set 2 years after the original, it becomes a little bit more problematic. But remember, the only part of Peter Weller you're going to see is a very small portion of his face, right? So you can do the whole magic de-aging thing a bit, and it'd be much less difficult if you have a predefined, just a set part of his face that you're going to actually see. It makes that a little bit easier. Makes that a little bit easier. It's still pretty complex and expensive, but whatever. But so I think a lot of it has to do with that big question. When does this RoboCop movie take place? Because if it takes place 20 years later, then there's no problem. Yes, he's more machine now than man, but still he's got human flesh on his face and that would age, right? So no problem. And if you're saying this is a true sequel to that original RoboCop, well, of course you bring back Peter Weller. Now, whether Peter Weller will want to do it, I don't know. As other people have observed online, Peter Weller's been more into directing lately, but I have a feeling they do a film like this and they want him back. I think he'll come back. I think he will. I'm just speculating. I can't base that on anything, but I have a feeling he would probably come back and do it. And to me, it makes perfect sense that it would be him. But it's also perfectly fine with me if you do say that this sequel takes place 2 years, 4 years, 5 years even, after the original RoboCop. I have no problem with them recasting either. That's fine. I completely understand that. But yeah, if it's set 20 plus years later, then yeah, it's Peter Weller. Of course it's Peter Weller. You got to go with Peter Weller, unless he doesn't want to do it, in which case that's fine. Go get somebody else. But to me, yeah, absolutely. Peter Weller all the way. All right, let's move on to topic number three.